Welcome back, everyone. Professor Cameron here. Now, in our last video, we went ahead and took this model and we cut this outside profile. We generated the toolpath to cut this outside profile. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to work off this. To this part, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to cut an inside pocket in here. And we're going to generate the profile or the toolpaths for that as well. The process is pretty much the same, but there are a few specific details that we need to pay attention to. So what we're going to do is on our left-hand side in our feature tree, we're going to go back to our main feature manager. This essentially brings us back to the SolidWorks that we all know. And we're going to modify this. We're going to go ahead and add in a pocket here. What we're going to do is we're going to select this top surface of our piece and create a new sketch on that. And we're going to create a slot in this as well, very similar to how we just created that outside profile. So what we're going to do is we're going to come up here, grab our slot tool, and we're going to grab that same tool, the center point straight slot. We're going to start right at the origin, come out to the side. And we're going to create a slot about that big. We're going to smart dimension this with a center to center of 4 inches. Now, here's where we have to pay attention. Like I talked about in the last video, we're going to have to start paying attention to how we are going to manufacture these parts, particularly with inside pockets like this. Because this pocket size is going to be driven by our tool diameter. Now, our tool that we're using for this instance is a half inch two-flute end mill, meaning our smallest radius cannot be smaller than 0.25, right? Our tool diameter is a half inch. Cutting radius on that is 0.25. We cannot have a feature with an arc smaller than 0.25. So to set our outside radius, we're going to go pretty hefty on this. We're going to go 0.5 radius so that it has a diameter of 1. Our cutter has a diameter of a half inch, so that should be no problem for us. In another tutorial, we'll go through and actually see what happens when our radiuses are too small and how we go ahead and fix that. But for now, we can set that to a half inch so that we have no issues. And then we're just going to cut this down using our extrude cut tool. We're going to cut this down half of an inch. So that way we still have this thick base here that we can hold in the vise. And we're not going to have any issues when we come time to cut this. Now, when we go back to CamWorks, we go back to our SolidWorks CAM tab. It's going to say that our model needs to be updated. We're going to go ahead and click yes. And then what we're going to do is we still have our rough mill for our outside perimeter. What we have to do now is add in the operation for this pocket. To do that, what we're going to do is select Extract Machinable Features again. And you'll see we have that same open pocket that we had before. Now we have a second feature here for ob round pocket 1. This is for this interior pocket. We're going to go through and generate the same generate operations plan. We're going to select Update. That leaves us with our same rough mill that we had for our exterior pocket, plus a new rough mill and contour mill. What we're going to do is we are going to delete this contour mill like we did with our first. Click yes. Then we're going to select and edit this rough mill. because we have to do the same editing that we did to our first operation. We're going to go to Tool. And right now, this is giving us a 3/4 inch to flute end mill. We don't want that. We want that same half inch end mill so that we don't have to do a tool change in between these two features. We're going to go to Tool Crib. We're going to select half inch and select. Do you want to change tool holder? Click yes. What we're going to do is go to feeds and speeds. Again, we're going to go to define by library and change that to operation. We're going to set our spindle speed to that same spindle speed that we calculated earlier, that 2400 RPM. And we're going to set our feed rate to 10. We can leave this at 25% and 50, the same parameters that we used for the exterior pocket. For roughing, we're going to run into that same issue that we had on the exterior, where it's going to leave 10 thousandths. We're going to set that to 0. We also have to come over here and edit our depth parameters. We're going to turn off these percentages and change these to 50 thousandths each. And C plane. Top of stock is fine. I'm going to change this also to top of stock. In this instance, it won't actually have an effect on our model. And we can select OK. We can go ahead and select generate toolpath. And that's going to go ahead and generate that same interior toolpath to match what we have on the outside. Now, when we go ahead and select simulate toolpath, it's going to simulate both the interior and the exterior cutting. It's going to run through it here, and it's going to cut that all down. Now, you'll notice here, it gives us a time for our second toolpath, 28 minutes. That's in addition to the first 59 minutes for that exterior cut. So our total cut time is going to be around an hour and a half. Now, in future videos, we're going to go through how we can cut that down, how to make our cutting a little bit faster, a little bit more optimized. But for now, this isn't a problem for us. Now, to post this, how we get this from our computer to our cutting machine is we can go to post process. We're going to select just a regular text file. And we can save this to a folder that we choose. Now, in order to post this file, what we're going to do is we're going to press this play button. That's going to run through and generate all of the code. Once that's completed, that file will appear in that folder as just a text file. And you guys will recognize this as our G code that we're all familiar with. Now, there are a few commands in here that won't quite work with our proto track machines, and we'll address that in a future video. But for now, this is essentially what we would send to our machine, and from there we would load and run this program. If you guys have any questions on this process, either adding interior pockets or exterior profiles, please let me know. And as always, have a nice day.